So I'm going to say a few words about funding Alzheimer's science here in a second. But after money, a distant second, but after money, the single biggest impediment to advancing Alzheimer's science is participation in clinical studies. We've got all these great ideas. I want to see how they work in human subjects. We need people to participate in clinical studies. Trial Match is the Alzheimer's Association's nationwide registry for participation in clinical studies. Anywhere, Texas, New York, Ohio, California, you can sign up, you can find research that's going on in your neighborhood. So we encourage people you have a trial match card, we encourage you to register. And there are lots of trials, by the way, that can be done online. There are trials that don't require spinal taps. Lots of ways to participate. Advocacy cards, I'll come back to that in a minute, and then the list of our programs are there, and our programs and Alzheimer's Association programs and advocacy table is outside to the right as you go out. So, a quick word about one of your sponsors today, the Alzheimer's Association. We are proud to be the national movement to address Alzheimer's disease and related disorders. I lead the Northern California, Northern Nevada chapter. We have 11 offices from Fresno to the Oregon border, and the upper third of Nevada is our territory. Our team is relentless, day after day, month after month, being there to help families through this journey for which they were often unprepared. We have a 24/7 helpline. Tonight, while I'm sleeping soundly at 2 o'clock in the morning, some trained staff will be on the other end of that phone to talk to families who need to make sense of this. We have a host of excellent educational programs. We have, 120, 30 caregiver support groups. We have lots of programs for early stage engagement. ALZ.org is a great go-to place to learn more about our work. We are also proud to be the largest private funders of Alzheimer's science in the world. We currently have over 400 active projects in 20 countries. We are agnostic about where the best research is to be found, but we are vigilant about trying to always look at the field for the best places to move the conversation forward. We're currently funding science at Stanford, at UCSF, at UC Davis, at the Gladstone Institute, and the Buck Center for Age Research in Novato. And while our own investments in science are important to us, 4 years ago, the President signed into law the National Alzheimer's Project Act. And a year later, the Secretary of HHS presented the country with the first ever national plan to address Alzheimer's disease. This was our baby. We dreamt of it. We helped to write it. We worked the Congress and the administration to see it into law. The national plan calls for disease-modifying treatments by 2025, and the scientists have told the planners that if you want what you say you want, it's going to take at least $2 billion in annual federal funding to get us there. $2 billion. Now, just a comparison, current federal funding for cancer is about a little over $5 billion. That gives you a little bit of comparison. In December, the Congress passed a budget, and if that wasn't news enough, in that budget was an additional $350 million to the baseline of National Institutes of Health Alzheimer's research funding, a 62% increase. Yeah. And I was back with 1,200 other advocates in Washington for our annual public policy forum here recently, and we're asking Congress in the next round of funding for an additional $400 million. So we're almost at the first $1 billion mark. We got to get that up to the $2 billion mark per the national plan. We're working on this. So who knows what this is? Walk to End Alzheimer's, yes. We have 19 walks to end Alzheimer's in our territory. We added a walk in Eureka this next fall. Eureka, up by the Oregon border. Most of you knew that, I know. But walk, you can draw a direct line from young volunteers with clipboards signing up advocates at walks from New York to San Diego and San Francisco to Reno. And that $350 million to the baseline of NIA funding for Alzheimer's science. That's how it happens. So I encourage you to fill out your advocacy cards. They're in your packet. And just a word about your advocacy card. When you register, we will send you email. It's what you do with the email that matters. Dr. Henderson and his colleagues, Dr. Attree and his colleagues, $350 million new dollars year after year after year after year in the baseline of NIA funding. It's there for scientists across the country. We're going to keep pushing on this, It's how we change the future for our kids and grandkids. So I thank you so much for being part of this.